Hi, this is Carl Polichuk with Small Biz Thoughts, and this is another SOP video for managed service providers. This is episode 2 on documenting a new server. Last time we talked about creating our spec sheets and putting them in a folder, and as you can see, I have an extra label here that can go right onto the new server. This is my favorite kind of server for the new Cloud 5-pack setup. This is a server that's going to live on site. It has very light duty, so it doesn't have to be a very powerful server, but it's my favorite because it's compact and it's reasonably priced. I'm going to own this server even though it lives at the client's site. That way I charge them $100 a month to have this server on site, but it totally belongs to my company. Now, the next piece of documentation is going to come right off of the packing label. For most distributors, your packing slip is going to actually have the serial number for the server. So it's going to be right on the packing slip. You can put it into your system, you can write it down, or you can just slip it into that folder, and now you know you've got the correct serial number. Obviously, you're going to match it up with the machine itself. Now let's go ahead and open the machine and see what we got. As you can see, we've got some documentation here. We might have a few extra cables that we're going to want to throw into that folder. We have all kinds of goodies that came in this box. We have the setup poster and the information for the documentation that ships from the manufacturer. Have some extra software that came with it. We have a tag for the integrated lights out information that needs to go into our documentation. We definitely don't want to have to come and look at the back of the machine in order to be able to access it remotely. So all that stuff has to get into our documentation. Now we're just going to collect it and put it in that folder. I don't know about you, but for me, one of the funnest things about a new server is opening it up for the first time to see what kind of cards we have, see if there's any new interfaces I need to be aware of. And to be honest, I want to make sure that all of the cards are properly seated and that memory is in place and that I know whether I got the memory I paid for and so forth. So I'm going to take it apart and I'm going to inspect it. I'm going to look inside. I'm going to make sure everything is the way it's supposed to be. Another important piece of documentation is to actually physically label the drives. This machine happened to have shipped with 4 1-terabyte hard drives. So we want to make sure that we label each of these on the drive itself. It does no good to label the slide where the drive is going to go into. That doesn't do you any good when there's a problem. You need the drives to be physically labeled so that when there's an issue and you need to troubleshoot, you can always put them back exactly in the order that they came out. We also put on that label the date that it went into service. That may be useful someday. It may not. Of course, your process may be different, but you should have a process. You should have a checklist that tells you exactly what you need to do whenever you open a new server and start building up a new machine. For Small Biz Thoughts, this is Carl Polichuk wishing you the best of luck in your managed service business.